So I recently made a video about why mammals survived over dinosaurs after the massive asteroid impact caused the mass extinction event at the end of the Cretaceous period. But a lot of you also wondered why avian dinosaurs, aka birds, survived over non-avian ones. So that is what we'll be talking about in today's video. First things first, there have been multiple mass extinction events throughout Earth's history, and understanding the selectivity of extinction events, in other words, how and why extinction events take out some species and not others, is super important for us to predict the impacts of anthropogenic environmental changes or other modern and future environmental changes and trends that might impact life and how we can combat those or prevent those from causing harm to ecosystems. The Cretaceous Paleogene mass extinction specifically occurred around 66 million years ago and was triggered by a massive asteroid impact and also potentially volcanism as well. I talk about the effects of the asteroid impact specifically in my KPG mass extinction event video, which I'll link up to the top right if you want to check it out. But this event is famous for wiping out the non-avian dinosaurs. And as is the topic of this video, we will be talking about how the avian dinosaurs, in other words, the birds, survived. Not only survived, but also rapidly diversified after that event and took over their modern ecological niche to become the successful group of animals they are on Earth today. However, like mammals, their story isn't that simple with regards to the KPG mass extinction. It's not that the non-avian dinosaurs went extinct and this helped the avian ones fill all the niches that just became open because all the non-avian dinosaurs went extinct. It wasn't quite that simple. Birds, just like mammals, were hit pretty hard by the extinction event and just barely survived. Most Cretaceous birds died. Archaic bird groups, those that were present in the Cretaceous period, but more distantly related to more modern birds, which I'll get to in a second, were hit a lot harder than those more modern style birds. The group that encompasses modern birds, which were also present in the Cretaceous, began diversifying leading up to the KPG boundary, leading up to the impact in mass extinction event, and obviously were able to take over after the fact because, one, the extinctions of archaic birds opened up a lot of new ecological niches. In other words, just like mammals were able to take over a lot of the non-avian dinosaur, large-bodied ecological roles after the KPG boundary in the early Cenozoic era, modern birds were able to take over, diversify, and radiate within the new niches that were opened due to the extinction of archaic birds. So, not necessarily non-avian dinosaurs, but actually niches that opened up because of avian dinosaurs that had gone extinct. So it's important that we remember that yes, avian dinosaurs survived, and that is the group that encompasses modern birds survived this KPG extinction event, but a lot of bird groups, a lot of other avian dinosaur groups did go extinct. It's also important to remember that early in the Cenozoic, after birds began to re-diversify and recover from the mass extinction event, large flightless birds re-evolved, almost looking like New Age dinosaurs, and these were nicknamed terror birds. And I will actually make a future video completely dedicated to them because just look at them. So yeah, not even dinosaurs went extinct, but they kind of almost re-evolved there for a second, it seems like. In any case, finally now getting to all of the factors that led to the survival over avian dinosaurs over non-avian dinosaurs, and these include the first one, which is birds' ability to fly allowed them to quickly escape from immediate dangers and ground-level threats to seek refuge. As I discussed in the recent mammal versus dino video as well, we talked about how their ability to escape either by burrowing or hiding because of their small size and certain, you know, protected regions really helped them, because there were a lot of immediate dangers, especially in the region close to the radius of impact. There were tsunamis that resulted from the impact, wildfires that spread enormous regions after the impact, ejecta falling from the sky. There were tons of ground level threats that if you could quickly escape from those by like flying away, that was much more beneficial than just trying to walk away on your legs, especially if you're just, you know, a huge target like huge non-avian dinosaurs were. We also see that flight seemed to be an advantage because Mesozoic flightless birds, those that were present leading up to the end of the Cretaceous, did not actually survive the KPG extinction event. They went extinct, and modern flightless birds, like those we have today, such as penguins, ostriches, and others, evolved later independently in the Cenozoic. They re-evolved flightlessness, just like the terror bird I showed on the previous slide that was present in the early Cenozoic. These flightless birds in the Cenozoic evolved flightlessness from the flying birds that survived the KPG extinction event. Only Cretaceous bird groups that flew survived the event. And this survival of flying groups also meant automatically that these groups were relatively small, since flight required a relatively small body size so that they could get up into the air. But their small body sizes themselves were also an advantage during the KPG extinction event over the large non-avian dinosaurs. This is because smaller animals have higher surface area to volume ratios, which make them more energy efficient. This is one of those other factors that I mentioned in the mammal video as well. Small avian dinosaurs, or birds, required much less food and energy to sustain themselves compared to the huge non-avian dinosaurs that required tons of food and energy. These huge non-avian dinosaurs would have been in a horrible spot to gain the energy that they need from food when resources became extremely limited. Again, like I mentioned in the mammal video, sunlight was potentially blocked for years post-impact due to all the dust, debris, ejecta, and even volcanic ash thrown into the atmosphere by both the impact and volcanism that was going on at the time, and this blocking of sunlight greatly limited photosynthesis and thus caused major shortages in food for the herbivorous dinosaurs, which fed the carnivorous dinosaurs, and this kind of worked its way down the food chain, causing cascades of extinctions. And so if you were small and required a lot less food, that was incredibly advantageous in this resource-limited time frame. Small birds may have also occupied ecological niches or ecological roles in ecosystems that were less affected by the event. And they were also potentially more adaptable to rapidly changing conditions. In other words, birds' ability to exploit a diverse range of habitats and food sources likely contributed to their survival. Again, another thing that I talked about in the mammal versus dinosaur video is specialization. And we talked about how a lot of the large non-avian dinosaurs had become so incredibly specialized within their ecological role, the niche, the role that they played in ecosystems, that specialization became a disadvantage when conditions changed rapidly. Again, becoming super specialized at one particular thing or one particular role that you play in the ecosystem can be incredibly beneficial when conditions are stable. But the minute conditions change, you've thrown all your eggs in one basket and you can't change or adapt that easily. Whereas when organisms are a little bit more generalized and adaptable to different habitats and food sources, yeah, they don't tend to play as dominant of roles in ecosystems, but when conditions change, they are way more likely to survive. Another potential factor that helped birds survive over non-avian dinosaurs at the end of the Cretaceous was the fact that they incubated their eggs and cared for their young. This likely increased the survival rate of their offspring as it provided protection and support during this time of environmental stress and resource limitation. That said, many other avian and non-avian dinosaurs that did go extinct at the end of the Cretaceous are also thought to have incubated their eggs and potentially even cared for their young in a similar way, so this may have played a role since most birds did it. But it's also important to remember that some other dinosaur groups also did this, and so it's just one of many factors, not like one of the major factors that made them survive. But birds also had a relatively short reproductive cycle compared to their huge non-avian cousins. In other words, they could lay and hatch eggs relatively quickly, which helped them recover and replenish populations much faster than the large non-avian dinosaurs with much longer gestation periods. Another factor that might have helped them survive over certain non-avian dinosaur groups is feathers. Feathers not only facilitated flight, but also provided insulation. This helped the birds regulate their body temperature during this time of rapid temperature fluctuation following the impact. Again, in that KPG mass extinction event video that I linked up to the top right earlier, I talk about how there were rapid and intense temperature fluctuations globally after the impact due to the fact that immediately after impact, at least in the region, which was pretty large because the impact was pretty large, that region experienced intense heating, especially in terrestrial systems, and again, massive wildfires, tsunamis, all of that stuff. Whereas, once the sunlight became blocked from the dust and ash and debris and stuff, for years that caused what we call an impact winter, or a drastic cooling event, right after the drastic and intense warming that occurred near impact. And then long term, more on kind of geologic time scales, there was a drastic warming event due to all the carbon and sulfur and other greenhouse gases emitted into the atmosphere due to the impact. And I talk about how that happened and why that happened and more about the exact time frames of each warming and cooling and then warming again in that video. But all that is to say, temperature was changing rapidly and fluctuating up and down, and being able to have this feather insulation and regulate body temperature would have been really great. That said, this is another factor, kind of like the brooding behavior, where some of the non-avian dinosaurs and other avian groups that didn't survive probably also had feathers. So it's just one of those extra factors that didn't play the major role in making them survive, but may have helped a little bit. It's also thought that about 24 million years before the KPG mass extinction event, many groups of large non-avian dinosaurs were already declining in diversity. This prolonged decline made them more susceptible to the sudden and catastrophic changes after the KPG impact. And it also likely allowed small avian dinosaurs or birds to diversify and take over the newly opening niches along with mammals, as I discussed this factor in that video as well. And then the last two factors that I will discuss are potentially, I think, the most compelling or played the largest role in helping these small avian birds to survive this mass extinction event. The first of which is big brains. Yeah, bird brain is a saying, but it's not all that accurate. Second to mammals, living birds have the most complex brains in the animal kingdom. And these big brains may have played a major role in their survival. The cerebral hemispheres, or a part of the bird brain, in living birds or modern birds are much bigger than in those that went extinct. This is the part of the brain where higher cognitive functions like speech, thought, and emotion occur. And it just so happens that every time we go into the rock record and find any part of bird skulls preserved, and we look and compare those that survived to those that didn't, we can see a clear trend of bigger brains in the ones that survived. So essentially, those that survived were probably smarter. And when you're smarter, you can probably escape immediate threats a little bit better. And the last and my favorite factor that helped the birds survive is their beaks. Many Cretaceous bird groups did have teeth, but others had beaks like they do today. It all just depended on their diet. But when we look at the rock record at this time during the KPG, we can see that the only ones that survived were those with beaks, whereas the toothed birds of the Cretaceous all went extinct at the KPG boundary. Again, since photosynthesis halted due to all the dust, ash, and soot that blocked sunlight for those, you know, however many years after impact, toothed birds and non-avian dinosaurs lost their food source. They lost, well, vegetation, which fed the animals that they ate. Whereas beaked birds could still forage on seeds, insects, fish, and other food sources that didn't disappear quite as fast. And again, they didn't need as much to survive because of their smaller bodies. So all in all, factors like being able to fly, being small in size so that you don't need that much food, the decline of non-avian dinosaurs that was already happening leading up to the KPG boundary, the adaptability of small flying birds to adapt to new conditions and new environments and new food sources, brooding behavior, taking care of their young and helping them be protected in the time of environmental stress, feathers for insulation during rapid temperature fluctuations, big brains and smartness, and having beaks, which helped them find food sources that weren't as limited. All of these factors helped birds, avian dinosaurs, survive into the present day Earth, compared to our sadly extinct non-avian dinosaurs. So I hope you enjoyed learning about what gave birds the advantage over non-avian dinosaurs at the end of the Cretaceous after the massive impact caused their mass extinction. If you haven't seen the recent video that I made about why mammals survived as well, you can check that out. I'll link it somewhere up on the screen here for you guys. And with that, references are linked down below, and I can't wait to see you guys in my next one. Bye.